Up until Sound of Victory, how have you evolved as an artist?
Thank you for knowing the beginning.
Oh, I love you.
Now I
love your stuff.
I don't. I hope I've stayed consistent to what the Lord has called me to do, but just evolved. Just growth in maturity, growth in my walk, growth in ministry, and not being afraid to be the square peg in a round hole. Anybody else?
Another one.
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Beautiful dress.
Thank you. I have a wonderful dressmaker in Baltimore, Maryland. Her name is Lottie Binyard. I gave her the material and two patterns on a Monday. She had it hanging on her hanger for me the next day on Tuesday.
Jewelry and the shoes.
The jewelry, she let me borrow her jewelry. She was a one-stop shop, and I found the shoes at Neiman Marcus.
All right. Okay, last question to the...
Yep. So you refer to yourself being a square peg in a round hole.
I do.
So what do you say to young people that are coming up behind you? You know, we see Anita Wilson, who's kind of on the same lines, you know, don't do a lot of that, you know, stuff or whatever. So what do you say to young people that might be kind of questioning themselves? Should I do this? How would you encourage them?
You stay true to who you are, because at the end of the day, that's all you have. Y'all are going to go home to your houses, to your families, and then I have to go home to my house and my family, and I have to be who I am 24/7, 365. So this is cool, this is nice, but at the end of the day, I got to be me, and you got to be you.
Okay, thank you.